On this week's YouTube Q&A, I want to answer a question that a lot of you guys ask, and that is, how do I combine multiple YouTube accounts into just one? That's coming up. Hey guys, my name is Tim Schmoyer, and welcome to another YouTube Q&A Thursday, where every week I just answer some of your questions about YouTube and the stuff that you guys are doing here. I am in a little different environment right now. I'm on the road on my way to VidCon, so thank you for putting up a little different quality and everything, but I still want to answer your question, and I still think it'll be just as good. A question that I get a lot is, Tim, I want to combine two of my YouTube channels together to be under one account. I have my first YouTube channel and my second YouTube channel, and they're both tied to different Gmail addresses. I actually just want them and other channels all to be under one Google account, under one Gmail address, rather than having to log in and out of all these separate things. And that has recently become possible, and I'm going to try my best and do this in a way that makes sense on this whiteboard here so that you guys can understand exactly how this works, so you understand what's happening, and then when we go in and actually show you how to do it, it'll make sense. So let's think of it as like we have these three kind of like categories here, okay? And over here is your Google account, which is gonna have, you know, your Gmail. It's gonna have like Blogger, analytics, and of course YouTube. Everything else is just kind of like right under there. And this is going to be like your first account, okay? Then you have the second account over here, which is also a Google account. And again, it has Gmail, but you probably don't use this account for much more than anything else other than YouTube. So you're just going to have YouTube here. And if you have other things attached to it, that's fine. Now, there's a separate category of Google accounts that has recently been added, and that is called a Google Plus page, okay? And they can do some things differently that these other accounts can't do. So the way it works is you can actually have your Google Plus, you know, personal account over here, which is going to be your personal profile, and then from that you can create multiple Google Plus pages, okay? And under each of these, but the cool thing now is that Google Plus pages can now manage YouTube accounts. So what you can do is take your YouTube account right here and you can move it to be right over here and make it attached to this page right above it. Effectively, what you're doing is you're removing it from over here and you're saying, instead, I want to be connected to this Google Plus page. And then together, these two become kind of like the same thing. I hope this is making sense here for you guys. So that's one thing. And so now your YouTube account is only connected to your Google Plus page. And the cool thing is, the more pages you have, you can have a Google, or you can have a YouTube account connected to each one. So you can have a YouTube account connected here. You can have a YouTube account connected here. And so now this one Google account is now managing three YouTube channels and thus three Google Plus pages. So what you really want to do is you want to say, how can I get this second YouTube account? How can I get that over here into a page? So the way it works, you can create a Google Plus personal account here, and then you would use that to create a Google Plus page, okay? And then what you do is this would be connected to that. And then again, same thing as I just did on the other side, this account, you're going to now connect that YouTube account to this page here. And so then it is no longer connected to this right here. It's just now connected to that page, which your Google Plus account manages as the owner. This is the owner, just like this is the owner of those pages. Okay, so this is kind of its own thing. So what you can do is you can actually have, you have one owner of the Google Plus page, but you can have multiple managers. So what you could do then is on your first Google account, you take this Google Plus account and you make it a manager of this page right here. Okay, so now you have one owner and you have one manager. Hopefully you can read that, of the same Google Plus page, and thus both of them can access and manage the YouTube account that's associated with that page as well. So eventually what you want to do though is you actually want to get rid of this account completely, right? So You can't make your primary Google account here. You can't make that the owner right away. You have to wait a certain number of days. I can't remember if it's like 30 days or 45 days or something like that. But after that number of days is expired and passed, then what you can do is this one can become the owner. And this one becomes the manager. And after it becomes the manager and your first account is now successfully being made the owner of that Google Plus page and thus also that channel, you can come back and you can erase this whole, whoops, wrong one. You can come back and erase this whole thing if you'd like, and you no longer need anything over here on this account. And now you've successfully transferred that original YouTube account. Let me change a different color, make it easier for you. This YouTube account right here that used to be over here, remember, it got transferred to this page, and now this account, Google Plus, became a manager. Later we shifted to be the owner, we made this page the manager, and then we just deleted the whole thing, blah, 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 it's all gone. And now that YouTube account is now successfully tied to the first Google Plus page and the Google Plus personal account, and thus that Gmail account. Hope that makes sense. Let me show you guys now exactly what you click on and everything to make this happen. So this is my channel right here on my desktop, and this is already connected to a Google Plus page, which you can see if I click right here, see this little funky thing. I wanna show you what I mean by this having its own, very own login setting, kind of being its own separate account. So if I click here on settings, right, and open this tab here, it's going to open up the settings for my Google Plus page. I'm in Google Plus right now. I can scroll down a little bit till I get to right here, third-party tools. You'll see your page's username is, and then I'll have your channel name, dash, a bunch of numbers, at pages.plusgoogle.com. And that's not an actual email address, that's just the login name you will use if you want to log in to a third-party app, such as the mobile app, the Google Plus mobile app, or a lot of third-party plugins for Google Plus require that you log in. And here you would set up a password. So now you have your own username and password set up just for your Google Plus page that makes it function like its own identity right here. So just wanted to show you guys that, because once you have your page, you'll need that, but that's not exactly what we're talking about here. So I'm just gonna close this tab and go back here. Now this one, like I said, is already connected to a page, and I have multiple managers of it here. See, I got this managers thing right here, and I can show you I've got, I'm the owner, and then I have two other people who are managing this account under, these are actual Google accounts, like Gmail accounts, that are managing this Google Plus page, and thus also my YouTube channel right here. So I'm gonna show you a different channel I have. You go here, I'm gonna go to switch accounts, and these are all of, you know, different email addresses, and here's the YouTube channels. You can also see all my channels right here at the bottom. If you click on that, you have this button where you can create a new YouTube channel, and you can create as many of those as you would like, and they will all show up just right here. So you can see I have a couple. This is the one I'm gonna show you, it's a demonstration. I'm not actually gonna go through the whole process because I don't want to link this anything, but I just wanna show you what it looks like, okay? So here, now I'm switched to this channel, and I'm gonna go to here to settings, and under the channel settings right here, overview, I can link this account with Google Plus, and if I click it, it'll ask me if I wanna link it actually to my personal account on Google Plus, and that's not really what I wanna do, because if it's linked to my personal account, I can't really transfer it. Like, let's presume that this is my second account, and this account right here, the God Rocks one, is one that I want to transfer to my primary account. Well, this, don't do it this way, it's not going to work, okay? So I'm going to skip out of that, I want to use different names actually here. So this advanced, that's the one you want to click on. Whoops, go away. Click on advanced right here, and then this right here, connect to a Google Plus page. So again, this is my second account that I want to transfer over to another account. I would come here on the second account, click connect with the Google Plus page, because remember, then I can connect my primary YouTube account with this Google Plus page. Both of these can share it, and then after 2 weeks, I looked it up, After 2 weeks, then I can transfer ownership of this page I'm about to create for this channel to the other, my primary YouTube thing. So it's giving me a couple options here. It says, Tim, you got a couple pages here that aren't yet linked with a YouTube account. Which one would you like to use? I could use my name. This is probably what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna create a new one right here. I'm not actually going to do it. Or if you've already created that page on Google Plus under this account, you can link it right here, select it here. But you could just enter, you know, name, you know, call this my family channel or, you know, whatever you call it. Just know that that will be the public page on Google Plus for your YouTube account. And then you go through, you know, agree to the terms and click next and go through it. I'm not going to do it because I actually don't want to right now, but that's how this would work. And then after you've created that page and your YouTube account is now successfully connected with that Google Plus page, it will no longer be connected to your YouTube, to your Google account. So let me give you an example, okay? So this right here, this account is my Google account that my Video Creators channel used to be connected to, but it's not anymore. See, if I go to my channel now, it'll say, hey, use YouTube. It'll ask me if I want to create a new channel because my Video Creators channel is no longer connected to this email address. It's now standing alone as its own Google Plus page and its own YouTube channel right here. So let's assume now that this Video Creators page is the Google Plus page I just created that I've tied my second YouTube channel to. And so now what I need to do is I need to go get that my primary Google account and connect it to that page as a manager so that both my second account and my first account are not now tied to the same Google Plus page and thus the same YouTube account. So to do that, I actually need to use Google Plus as the owner of that page. And right now, this is the owner of that Video Creators page. So what I'm going to do is I am going to go down to that page right here as the owner of that page. And over here to the side, click on Settings, and then go click on Managers right here. And here's that button, I can add a manager. So what I'm gonna do is I can either add the name, as you saw here, or the email address of my primary account. You know, so this is my, I'm on this page managing it as my secondary YouTube account. I want to put in the email address of the Google account that I want to eventually transfer my YouTube channel to, which would be like my primary Google account. So I would just type that in there, and then it'll show up here as a manager. Your first page, that first account, will get a notification, and it will have to go approve, like, yes, I do want to be a manager of this page. And then after they approve it and they say, yes, I do want to be a manager, again, you'll have them, they'll all show up right here. You can add multiple managers. And then after 2 weeks, see what I can do as a manager here. See, let's say Ronnie Bintzer is my first account. And go here and I can say transfer ownership to Ronnie Bintzer. And that will do is that'll make him owner. It'll make my account right here a manager. And then after he successfully becomes manager, my second account can then come here and leave the page completely. And now the page will be completely transferred to, you know, Ronnie Bintzer in this case, or in your case, your primary Google account / YouTube channel. And the way you would then access it after it's transferred is just the way I showed you here. You know, just go to youtube.com/, you know, whatever, and then it'll be up here. You can just go to switch account, and all the accounts you have tied to your channel will be right here, and also under all channels. Well, I've logged out now of the other two, but they'll all show up right here. I hope that makes sense. I know it's a bit confusing and there's a lot of different things to consider and click on and keep track of, but if you have any questions while you're going through this, comment below and I will do my best to help you guys out. Also, if any of you guys have done this before and have some tips and ideas and things that have worked well for you in this whole transferring process, also comment with that below as well. So thank you guys for hanging out with me. I'd love to have you subscribe if this is your first time hanging out. Every Thursday, we just do some Q&A to help you guys out with your content here, just like you saw here. Also, on Tuesdays, we take a look at what's happening in the online video industry, news, updates, things that are happening that affect the way we are building our audiences and creating content here on YouTube. And then on Wednesdays, I give you guys some YouTube just advice and ideas and tips and suggestions. So I'd love to have you guys subscribe. Thank you for letting me be a part of what you guys are doing. And I will see you guys again next week. Bye.